Hello.
Hello.
It looks like they're probably just playing that trailer one more time before the real thing starts.
Country Roads!
Get ready.
Take me
Country
home!
Country Roads. Anyways, hi. It's time for Bethesda's E3 conference.
Let me
scoot the mic forward more.
Yeah.
There we go.
Life is old there.
So be careful with bumping the table there.
Older than the trees. But younger than the mountains. They blow in the breeze somehow.
Somehow. Well, if you remember, mountains are actually ancient trees.
Oh, that's true, actually. You're right.
If you believe
stumps.
The strangest of flat earthers.
Are those people even related to the flat earth people, or what?
I think they're a weird subset sometimes. I don't know. Anyways, it's Bethesda. I'll post it again in the chat.
He'll post it again, but we have a bingo
we
card.
We have a bingo card.
For Bethesda.
Let's just double check I have the right link in here. Yeah. So, here's the link to our bingo card. It's also in the directly below our stream on our Twitch page. You might have to refresh the page for the panel to show up.
But yeah, check it out.
Check it out. Let's
got
see.
Got some stuff.
What do we got on here? That's the same thing.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
That's okay. You just gotta recapture it. There you go. There it is.
Yep. So, we got VR games.
You gotta go
new
quick.
New IP.
Go quick.
VR games, new IP, a normal conference, no complaints, Elder Scrolls mobile game, jokes about Rage 2 leak, one audience member is very loud, a Rogue Warriors sequel, Quake is still here, I guess, everything is coming out pretty soon, somehow nothing is Battle Royale, Elder Scrolls announced, no footage. Something happens with Prey, I guess. Fallout is the free square.
That's the free square.
British celebrity voice actor, old-timey music, Doom 2. Skyrim is ported to everything that Skyrim isn't on, including toasters and graphing calculators.
Yeah.
Talking up Elder Scrolls Online. Doom Guy talks now. Wolfenstein DLC. BJ goes to Mars. Fallout Shelter sequel.
And it's out
today. They released something today. Starfield is real. Cute presentation style. And also, Focus is still on single-player games somehow. And here we go.
Oh, that was perfect. Although I guess you technically had 30 seconds left to do it.
Yeah.
She told me to rap, so I rapped. the flashback to the EA stream yesterday.
I've never really had, Bethesda has not done many conferences. It's only, their third one, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Their conferences have, always been fine.
Yeah.
And they usually announce games I'm into.
Ooh.
Oh, wow, look at this.
They gave them those electronic cool thingies.
I will clarify, though, I do know people who work at Bethesda. And I also applied for a job there.
I'm anticipating the announcement of hiring Chip Cheesem as the video producer. That's what I want to happen.
So, yeah, there's that clarification, I guess. Mm-hmm. I mean, I literally applied just a few days ago. So,
So everybody,
don't you dare
at the powers that be.
Don't you dare say I sold out.
And harass them.
I need a job, okay?
Harass them to hire Chip Cheesem. We have
different interests. No, because
that's
don't do that.
That's totally normal to do.
Do not do that.
Do the gamer thing and don't do that.
We aren't all developers, but it takes all of us.
Look, these people could be you, even the cafeteria guy.
Wow, I can't wait to make sandwiches for everybody.
Very seriously. We try and break things.
This could be us living in Rockville.
Here's our new recruitment video. You were right. We should have put this on the bingo card. You suggested a space that was a video just showing everyone's families.
Everyone's happy families were here at Bethesda. And you said, no, that shouldn't be on the bingo card. But it's their shtick, and I think it's cute.
They did it again.
I really like their shtick with the families.
And interact with our community.
You're right. I'm listening to the monitor. This video does seem a little quiet compared to us. So I'll fix that.
Oh, you could be playing foosball.
And play them.
Look at the babies.
We're not just living the dream. We're creating it. We are all.
There, it's louder.
Everyone's so cute.
How may I direct your call? Mm-hmm. You can start the show.
ADR.
She's got a great voice for an ADR lady. I think that counts as cute presentation style, but there's going to be cuter other things. We're thinking like cartoony animation.
I mean, the previous one,
that.
They had like this unifying, like, little theme part.
Yeah.
Bethesda theme part.
It was so
thing.
Cute.
It was cute looking.
Woo! Yeah!
I saw that part once before. I saw that video editor. I wonder how long the video game.
This is a wide conference hall. Oh, it's on both sides. Look at this. This is a weird
stadium. That's weird.
Did they take over in medieval times? Because this would be like the layout of a medieval times restaurant, where in the middle would be the horses and stuff.
And just put a jumbo, two jumbo friends in there.
Yeah. Huh. I'm cheering for the Red Knight. He's the hunkiest one.
Thank you guys very much.
I hope the hawk doesn't fly into the rafters.
You look good. You guys ready to go?
Thank you for complimenting how I look.
And I'm delighted to be back on stage for Bethesda's fourth annual E3 showcase. Now, we've got all kinds of surprises.
Oh, it's their fourth. This is your third.
Whether you're here with us in the audience or you're one of the millions who are watching around the world, settle in. Get ready for the very best in gaming. Our theme this year is Create, and it's a theme embraced by our 10 studios spread around the globe, the incredibly talented folks who make the Bethesda games that you'll soon be playing. But as you saw in our intro video, it's not just developers. Everyone at Bethesda is a part of the team.
Chat's right. I forgot to tag you again on Tweet. I'm sorry.
You are so inconsiderate.
I'm sorry.
You create your own adventures, stories, and experiences, and it's your passion for games that drives us every day to strive for excellence.
Come on.
Come on. Some guy there just like vibrating, like, shut the fucking thing!
What?
Games like Prey.
If that guy goes a couple more times, he's gonna check off the loud guy box.
Loud guy box.
Wolfenstein 2. We even released exciting updates for The Elder Scrolls Online. We brought full open world VR with Fallout 4 and Skyrim, plus Doom VFR. And we even released our first two games for the Nintendo Switch. So we were thrilled when Metacritic named us the top publisher in the industry.
I didn't know that. Good for you guys.
All of our games. But tonight is about the future. We're here to show you where we're headed and the games that we're creating that you'll soon be playing.
I'm fine with more Skyrim ports if they somehow become like really ambitious, like making them work on like a smartwatch or something.
Oh my god,
someplace where there's no reason why it should be there. Just make it the new like Doom 2 or Doom of, you know, just porting it to everything.
Best known for their low prices and ability to keep a secret.
Oh,
so let's they get joked about started with a look.
They joked about Rage 2.
I'm gonna count that because jokes about Rage 2 leak.
Mm-hmm.
That
yeah
absolutely.
They're doing the thing that counts as
checked
the bingo card.
Checked it off.
Right there.
Yeah.
Bring the chat back.
Sorry.
Andrew WK.
What? Why is he here?
All right! Are you out at the right time?
My name's Andrew WK.
What's he doing here?
And I'm the new celebrity voice actor for Fallout.
Oh.
Are you ready to rage?
I love Andrew WK. I don't know anything about his music, but he just seems like a really positive guy. And I appreciate that.
I like his stage presence.
He parties hard. You can respect that. I I can never be mad at Andrew WK unless he did something really fucked up, but he's never done anything fucked up. He's just a nice man.
He just seems like he's nice.
He's like a young Jack Black. So talented. I didn't know he played piano. He has looked the same age since 2000, by the way.
I've never really looked at him and thought, like, oh, he's older now. Weird.
He is immortal. He has looked the same for the last 18 years.
Yeah.
Healthy guy.
What?
Tiny head bob from that guy. He always seems like he's having fun, too. He's not faking it. He's always having fun.
Oh, he's like 40? Oh, my God.
Get the hell out of town. Take a bus. That's amazing. I'm sad that he's playing for all these people that are too awkward to dance or jump up and down or anything. It's a whole stadium of nerds that hate dancing and stuff. He's got beautiful teeth, too.
I'm jealous of him.
Oh, I'm breaking up with you, and I'm getting with Andrew WK.
God damn it.
Sorry, hon. I love him. This is the extremely rare musical sequence that I don't hate at E3.
Somebody in the chat just claimed that Andrew WK has an album where he performs all the original versions of songs from Mobile Suit Gundam.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. This is unfortunately a very unreceptive crowd to partying. That's as jaunty as they're gonna get right there.
It's called Gundam Rock, the
Gundam
album.
Rock.
For people who watch this at some point and want to, like, find that album.
Everyone just respectfully nodding their heads, being like, where's the video game? How do you headbang and do piano? That's kind of impressive.
That seems hard. I'd fall over. I would just fall over backwards.
I rolled. Love that guy.
That's fun. It's fun just to have Andrew WK show up for not really any real reason.
He's great. What a guy.
Anyways, he plays Andrew WK in Rage 2. Oh,
that'd be great. Give it up again for Andrew WK. God, the height difference between these guys. I love it.
I bet I'm even smaller than that guy on the left.
These two guys look like human Sonas for Muppets. in a nice way.
I'm the studio director at id Software.
And I'm Magnus Nedfors, game director at Avalanche Studios.
Oh my God, what a hunk.
And hello. We're here to say that Rage is
his name,
back.
I wasn't even paying attention to that. Apparently his name is Magnus.
Magnus.
Now, we had a ton of crazy ideas when we started.
I'm fucking jealous.
And we needed you wish your name was Magnus?
Is his name really Magnus?
Yeah. When you're from Norway, your name could be Magnus.
Fuck. In all of Man. Studios games.
And as we're about to show you, they delivered.
Yeah, did people actually like Rage, the first one? I didn't. I don't remember people caring.
I heard there were. I heard there were like issues or something that kept it from being as good as it could have been. And like when they announced Rage 2, I think the general reaction was that people were kind of like, what? A Rage 2?
Huh?
It wasn't, like, bad, but, huh?
Whose line is it?
Yeah!
Whose line is it?
Uh-oh.
Are we introducing the thing?
Well, speaking for everyone at Avalanche Studios, this is really a dream to come true for us. The world of Rage 2 is perfect for our style of gameplay. But even more exciting than that has been to work with these guys at id Software. These guys invented the first-person shooter.
That's true. They did.
Yeah.
Yep. They have, like,
they still all the best shooters out there.
Fallout guys, masks in the crowd.
Oh, the, yeah.
Fallout Boy.
So it's been a really great collaboration to bring you the most insane open-world shooter you have ever played.
Oh, is there, like, a tech issue?
Transports players into a dystopian future, devoid of society, law, and order. No, you play as Walker, the last
the
ranger
Texas Ranger.
Now,
wait, Walker's a ranger?
Wizard in the chat says, fun fact, my brother is also named Magnus.
Good for you.
It's a real name, and not just like a cool name you get when you're
a fucking dude who
rides around in a mech suit or something.
Mech suit Magnus, that's what they call
it. Mech suit Magnus, that's me.
Rage 2 playable at our booth at E3. But we've got for you an extended look at the world and gameplay.
Chat says, I think this guy sounds like me when I'm older.
Let's check it out right now.
I think he sounds like you. You have a deeper voice than him a little already. Maybe it's just a teleprompter issue than a tech issue.
Yeah, maybe.
Global extinction event.
100% of the Earth's population dead.
God turned his back on humanity long ago.
What?
It wasn't a war. It wasn't global warming. It was a fucking asteroid.
Yeah, Chip will eventually evolve into a Magnus at level 35.
Can't wait.
Yeah. Trying real hard to level him up.
An orphan of this wasteland. An army of mutants killed everyone I ever loved. All that's left is hate. Fear and the need for survival.
This game also has neon colored mohawks in it. Is that like gonna be a thing coming back now?
Well, maybe it's like a reflection of society. Everyone's got cool colored hair now.
I'm not seeing mohawks though.
I mean, mohawks are just like they're good signifiers for like these guys are gritty.
Yeah.
They're mean and gritty and they got guns.
This is funny how,
Hello? World of Rage 2.
In a moment, oh, this is really quiet.
First into the Eden spaceport mission, where Walker, our main protagonist,
this sounds really quiet to me.
Huh?
That will aid him in his quest to take down the authority. What do you guys think in the chat? Is it too quiet?
It might be overrun by bandits.
You see that fucking truck? You can go there!
They say it's a little quiet, but...
Yeah, I can bump it more. Yeah, it's like... The instant this trailer came up, like the trailer itself is quieter than the rest of their audio. Mm-hmm. I mean, one of the big promises are like, I think, things people thought the game was going to be about was like, okay, it was like a combination of first-person shooter, but also like death race game or something like that. But it was actually a lot smaller and more like linear, and so you couldn't really drive your vehicle everywhere, which is what it kind of felt like the game was going to be. And this looks like it's kind of more making that promise of being able to just like drive everywhere.
My question is, if it's a post-apocalyptic world, where's everybody getting their hair dye?
That's radiation poisoning.
Are they spray painting their hair, maybe?
Maybe.
Whoa, vaporwave filter activated.
It sings! Rocket, rocket, singing song, Judah.
It mounts on the wall. It's motion sensor activated. Is the rocket the crusher talking acting? If it can be yours, wild flat.
That's a whatever. The fancy expensive edition will come with that.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah, that's probably the pre-order
that's
thing.
That's the pre-order.
The super deluxe edition. Yeah.
It's gonna come with the Billy Bass thing. That was a good transition. That slide transition.
That was a
good transition too. Nice trailer. Yeah.
They're transitioning on impacts.
Very nice. Man, compare this to the Tomb Raider trailer. makes Tomb Raider trailer
really
look like YouTube crap.
Of that weird thing.
Ooh, that was nice. That was a good cut.
There's some advantages to editing a first-person game. That is, you can whip the camera real fast whenever you want, mm-hmm. and then just put apply more motion blur to it, and it's
and
just
you have
it's
a transition.
A wipe. It's just a wipe.
The rules. Video editing insights from a guy who wants a video editing position at Bethesda.
Mm-hmm.
Wink, wink.
Pod made it.
I know, and so does the authority. Hurry, get the untainted nanotrites and get out. Also for you, there is an extra boon. Something that will make you a veritable superhero.
Elevator's still running? So far, so good. Looks like Ranger Walker's gonna get a bit of a boost today.
No chat, this is not fake team speak. I don't even think
this is the protagonist talking to himself. Can you imagine if they had fake team speak, but they used like professional voice actor sounding people?
Oh boy.
That would be so confusing and really funny.
Oh, hell yeah.
I just totally owned that guy.
Why is the voice actor for Duke Nukem saying this? Oh, I see. They're trying to do team speak where somebody has a Duke Nukem soundboard.
I've got balls of steel.
You ever get real mad and just scream so hard your vision turns pink?
Occasionally, yeah.
Chat says, it's time to chew ass.
Oh, there's so many good cuts in this.
Mm-hmm.
Neat.
I mean, it's a similar editing style from what I remember for their trailers for Wolfenstein 2 last year. They had a lot of similar types of cuts.
Hey, it's nice.
Oh, right. The card game. I should have put that in the
How's it going, everybody?
Card.
I'm Christian Van, who's the community manager for the Elder Scrolls Legends.
He looks like a YouTuber.
For the past year, we have taken what I think is
like,
the best digital card game.
I don't think he looks like he just looks like a normal
new
YouTuber.
Cards,
a normal YouTuber,
modes,
not the racist kind.
And much more.
Is this...
But we wanted to push ourselves even further. So tonight,
this is just something that's like an identifying mark. That's like, oh, this is the YouTuber that's going to do something racist at some point. Like somebody tweeted that Nero from Devil May Cry 5 was like, why does he look like a YouTuber I've never heard of until he does something racist?
Later this year, on Nintendo Switch, Xbox One, and PlayStation 4. But there's no reason to wait to play the game that Apple awarded Best of the Year in 2017. Download The Elder Scrolls Legends for free and join me tonight on PC, mobile, or tablet. And any progress you make in the game will be carried over to the console versions through your BethesdaNet account. And now, let's take a look at the future of Legends. And see why this isn't just my favorite card game, but will soon be yours as well.
He did a good job for the community manager.
One game is all it takes. But Legends.
Tired of playing card games in a void.
I wish it wasn't a void.
This is story. This is competition. This is easy.
Wish you could play a card game in a void with someone else and the couch inside of it.
And some gold.
This is a 5-minute train ride.
Gold?
The dragon.
This is a 5-hour marathon.
Oh, sweet, I'm buying it. I want a beard.
It sucks. Don't actually. You have to shave it. That's the part that sucks.
This is for those who want magic at their fingertips. This is for those who want dragons at their command.
When is somebody, I agree with what the chat just brought up, when is somebody going to do a card game that plays like that one Yu-Gi-Oh! Series where you have to play the card game while riding motorcycles?
Yeah. When?
When that happening?
from ZeniMax Online
Studios. Maybe when the
Online
Rage 2 card game comes out.
Matt Firearm.
His name's Matt Firearm?
Thank you.
That's what it sounded like, but I'm pretty sure.
Lower Chiron, help me.
Thanks, everyone.
Oh, Firearm. Okay.
Matt Firearm.
Firearm.
Yep. I'm Magnus Mexu, and he's Matt Firearm.
Before we get started tonight, I just want to do a shout-out. It was really great we started the showcase tonight with the video highlighting the really talented people that are behind the scenes to make all of these great games possible.
Where is it? Talking at the Elder Scrolls Online.
So standing here on stage, I'm representing a whole lot of amazing people at ZeniMax Online Studios that I go to work with every day. It's a great honor and privilege. So, I go to work with them every day, but at night, I go home, log into Elder Scrolls Online, and I get to play games with you guys, the best gaming community in online gaming.
Buttering him up.
Is he talking about me?
We are such big fans of what we do. We play the games just as, you know, we make them, and we play them just as much as you guys do. It's what we do. You know, so you might not know it, but we're right there alongside. I'm playing there with you. I'm running dungeons. I'm exploring Tamriel, questing, crafting, decorating my house, PvPing, stabbing. Yeah, that was me. And I'm really humbled to say that the Elder Scrolls Online community just keeps getting bigger. We're over 11 million players now.
Someone said about the short man and the tall man, I love Pop Team Epic.
And over a million of those came in just the last year alone.
Are you a motherfucker?
So last year was really great for us in a whole lot of ways. We were named MMO of the Year for the third straight year. We released Morrowind. A lot of great DLC, and just last week we released Somerset, the latest chapter in the Elder Scrolls Online. It's been you know, received with great critical acclaim. Everyone loves it. You get to travel to the island home of the High Elves for the first time in 20 years. It's great for new players. If in the off chance you aren't playing Elder Scrolls Online, this is a great chance to jump in and play. And of course, all you veteran ESO fans are already there. But we're not done there. We make DLC every quarter.
Somebody said that Bethesda, like right after that Rage 2 thing happened, they tweeted the special edition, and yet it has the talking.
We're already working on our great plans for next year. But before that, the next DLC coming out is a dungeon DLC named Wolf Hunter, based on werewolves.
Don't shout things over the man. Wait till he's done to shout.
He's a big werewolf man. He's way into the werewolves.
Was he shouting, oh, big werewolf man?
So you guys have all been asking for a deeper dive into Argonian lore and culture.
Oh, yeah, baby. Give me that Argonian lore and culture. So definitely know what that is.
So there's one theme that runs through all of the Elder Scrolls Online's content, and that is great storytelling. From the launch game through all the DLC and chapters, it's really, really what holds the game together. But it's not just the stories that we as developers create for you guys to experience. It's also the stories that you create together when you play this great virtual world. So I'm going to leave you tonight with a video highlighting just some of the amazing stories and memorable characters that you'll meet on your ESO journey. Thanks, everyone. See you in Tamriel.
Man, this quiet. This audience isn't being loud enough. There's no guy who's really going for it. Well, it was a lady last time who was actually going for
it.
That's true. Like, she was going for it in a way that it felt like one of the developers' moms was there, and she was super proud.
Aww.
And she didn't understand any of the things she was seeing, but she was like, my baby worked on that!
I bet they're such a family-oriented company.
Yeah, maybe.
It's probably the mom. What if that?
Man, fucked up.
Oh, I did? When did I do this?
Huh? Oh. I was looking at you going like, oh, you see that guy get fucked up? It was kind of funny that he just kind of...
Like, you reclaimed the Ark Kingdom. I was like, oh, did I?
You did that like last week, remember?
Right.
Yeah.
Right, yeah, I did reclaim the Ark Kingdom. It's been such a busy week, though, I forgot.
Yeah.
I remember that part, though. clockwork guy.
Did the cat man have a colored mohawk too?
Well, look at that bug.
That guy's got a pot on his head. Oh no. That guy sat on that guy. Man, everyone's all about shooting lasers in this world.
I mean,
it's all laser shooting happening here.
We could shoot lasers. Wouldn't you be doing that?
I mean, yeah, but there's a lot of people that have that power. It's a lot.
It just means their lasers are going to collide, and more likely nobody's going to get hurt. What's this? Doom? Prey?
Prey Doom? Pray tell, is it Doom?
It's Doom.
Doom.
Surprise, it's Conker somehow.
Oh, he tricked me.
Snuck into this conference, huh? There's no streetlights in hell.
Yeah, that's extremely Doom.
Are there streetlights in hell?
Maybe.
There could be. I don't know much about hell's infrastructure, so...
Oh, it's hell on Earth now because Optimus Prime from the first game took the magic glowy sword?
Yeah, probably.
Okay, does Doom Guy talk? Like, I made this square thing and maybe Doom Guy will talk.
War never changes. That's what his first line is.
Mm-hmm. Hooray, eternal. It's a new Doom.
It's not infinite, it's eternal. They're synonyms, it's but it's not the different. Same word. Different.
Thanks so much. I'm Marty Stratton, executive producer of Doom Eternal.
Doomy.
And I'm Hugo Martin, creative director on Doom Eternal.
Doom Eternal.
Doomy.
Doomy Turtle.
In 2016, we launched our reboot of Doom and have been blown away by your support and excitement for the game.
This guy looks like Chandler Bing.
Thank you. In fact, it's a combination of your passion and our team's love of making Doom that has motivated us to deliver even more.
So we're back to announce Doom Eternal. An awesome, awesome new sequel to Doom. For the past 2 years, it's been so
that guy's just trying to interrupt people at this point.
Like
that guy's being a dick.
And I got to tell you, we're right there with you. Like, you want the
shut up, dude. This is a conversation with you.
When's it come out?
Well, we got it. You want even more badass demons? Well, there are twice as many in this game.
Is that a factual
you
statistic?
See hell on Earth? Well,
we're already in it.
Look who we found president. What can I say?
Is to show you some of the things that you might not be expecting.
Interruption.
That's right, including a ton of features.
That's right. Not only can use chainsaws on demons as you did in the first game, Doom Guy can hold two chainsaws now.
I was trying to interrupt you, but you did a really good job keeping your sentences going.
Yeah. Of course, you can tune in online to catch all the fun. But until then, we want to thank everyone who continues to play Doom.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
You know what? I'm going to check off Loud Guy now.
Yeah, Loud Guy is loud. It's true.
How's Quake. Everybody feel Quake tonight? Is still here, I guess.
Oh, Quake is still here.
Check that off.
Just like a little hype or like crazy hype right now, right?
A medium amount of hype. I mean, we're all a little tired.
I'm Joshua Boyle, community
that guy's wearing a,
for Quake.
Oh, Champions. I thought that was a Sonic shirt. That guy just to the right of him is wearing a Mickey Mouse shirt.
Oh,
misinterpreted it as Sonic the Hedgehog.
It does look a little Sonic-y when he's kind of hunching over. It looks a little attitudinal.
Yeah.
Which has evolved with community in mind. And
I'm bothered by the placement of the Quake logo on his shirt being like so up on his shoulder there.
That is kind of strange that it's up that high. I think it'll be more on the pec.
Yeah, like on the shoulder, like, yeah, like on the,
whoa, look at
the breast pocket.
What was on the back of his shirt?
These days we're hearing a lot of talk about
esports. Couldn't decipher it.
But Quake has been there from the very beginning.
Chad's posting that dumb Sonic face.
In fact, we started hosting competitions at QuakeCon over 20 years ago.
Quake can vote.
And this year, we'll expand on our legacy as the original eSport.
Can't tell what's on the back there.
Everything from intense
grassroots full color
competitions
and, I don't know.
To it's major a big spread.
At QuakeCon.
My request for Quake is to put in the original Quake jump sounds for every character, no matter who you're playing as, so they all go, whoop!
We've been doing this for a long time, and we're continuing to build. With more
what's his face back there? I forget his name.
Phantom Boys.
Than ever before.
Yeah, that guy. He's back there.
And to the left of him was someone else, but I didn't get enough of a look at him to see who was. Oh, it's Daniel Dwyer.
Yes.
That's fun for everyone. Whether you're a Quake dad or a brand new
Quake
dad.
That's why we just added a bunch of new features to make it even easier. For you and your
like
friends to jump in and get
back
good
there.
It's what?
It's like Quake Guy on the back of his shirt. It's an illustration of Quake Guy with some weapons over his head.
Hmm.
I think.
We're still in early access, but tonight we want to welcome
Chad just saying hashtag Quake Daddies.
For this week only.
Get a close up on the back of his shirt. I want to see it better.
To everyone through a trial of our free to play version before it even launches.
He chuckles a lot. There he is.
There they are.
Plus,
they went, oh, it's those guys.
Oh, famous
download
people.
Download this week. You can stay and keep playing Quake Champions for free even after the trial closes.
Those two are just like constantly joking about something back there. Like,
and start playing with me and all of my Quake family tonight.
Maybe they're also talking about his shirt.
Yeah.
They're talking about his shirt on the back of it.
Don't miss your chance to join one of the most passionate and welcoming communities in gaming. Now,
you should exit stage by going,
for a taste of what you'll be playing tonight after our showcase is over, check out our new trailer for Quake Champions.
How does he manage to like get back? It's so dark.
Yeah. Maybe there's like an attendant like at movie theaters with a flashlight.
Come this way, sir.
We'll find out how tasty soup.
I have no loyalty to Quake, unfortunately.
I probably would if I had played it more as a kid, but I just didn't do PC stuff until a little bit too late for Quake. I played a lot of Quake at my last job because Alex.
Right,
Quake.
He was laying to Quake.
He was really fucking good at Quake, though, and so I would get owned a lot.
Mm-hmm. He was very serious about being competitive.
He was
in
very
general.
Serious about, esports.
Esports.
He wanted to find the metagame in fucking Mario Party 6.
The metagame was being sober enough to understand that you need to get the stars to win. That was my metagame right there.
Yeah. Yeah, the other part of the metagame is that you have to be Waluigi. And then you win no matter what.
Win minigames, get coins, buy stars. Once you hit 2-star, that's how you win. That's my strategy.
It's Mystery Science Theater? Okay. Oh, look, I can cross off Prey on my thing
now. Oh, there you go. Cool, cool.
Now, BJ just needs to go to Mars.
Studios here in Austin, Texas. It's been 1 year since we launched Prey, and we want to send a big thanks to our incredible fan base for your support.
We've been so inspired by your passion and enthusiasm, and as a way of showing our appreciation, we're rolling out a huge free update for Prey tonight.
Oh, it's free! Oh,
the next time you fire up Prey,
and it comes out today. I can cross that off too.
It comes out today.
New game plus,
which was a big fan request,
and survival mode, which should be an interesting challenge for our most hardcore fans.
But that's just the beginning. We are really excited to tell everyone that we've also been working on a new Prey DLC. An infinitely replayable experience called Moon Crash.
It's a new twist on Prey where the enemies, hazards, and loot are all different each time you play.
We're so excited. We can't wait to
show
you.
Look out behind you!
The moon is a harsh mistress.
I played Prey. I liked it, but I never got around to finishing it.
Yeah, you didn't finish it. To get for you. Some other games popped into your life. I forget which ones are.
Yeah. Oh, they're using this song?
Let's get to work.
What song is this?
You spin me right round.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh my god, it is.
Yeah.
That's hilarious.
Yeah, see? I knew it.
That's hilarious. A hilarious music choice. I can't believe you recognized it for me.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think enough people have unassociated this song with Meat Spin by this point?
yes, because a lot of people weren't on the internet when that happens. It's thoroughly unassociated with that, I think. This new stuff they're showing looks pretty cool, though.
Just reminded the chat of Meat Spin.
Yeah, it's like ancient history in internet
time.
It's
an old meme, I guess.
Oh. That seemed pretty cool. That makes me want to go back and finish Prey.
Oh, look, they lived.
All right, before we begin,
good.
Yes, thank Mom, God. I'm still alive. No, I'm not a mimic.
She knows Hang what on. That is. Your mom knows that.
There. I just want to make sure nobody tries to smack you because I saw Pete Hines with a wrench backstage a second ago.
Thank you.
He always has a wrench with him.
That's just him. That's his lucky wrench.
Like all arcade games, Prey is about playing your own way, and Moon Crash is no exception.
So you just saw a lot of cool stuff that's available tonight, but we're not done yet. We have one more surprise coming later this summer called Typhon Hunter.
Typhon Hunter is a lethal game of hide-and-seek, where one player goes head-to-head against five other players who get to be mimics.
And just like in Prey, the mimic players can disguise themselves as everyday objects. So, you know, things like
has a lot
chair,
of hilarity potential.
A coffee mug, a space banana.
It's fucking prop hunt. It's the prop
works,
hunt mode from, like, Gary's Mod or whatever.
Right, Susan?
Absolutely not. Probably not.
No!
What does this mean?
Anyway, Typhon Hunter is a tense multiplayer mode that requires teamwork and improvisation and a very high tolerance for jump scares.
Before we go, I just want to say thanks on behalf of the whole team at Arcane Studios to all of our fans around the world who have played Prey and love it.
Played
we made
Prey.
This game for you. And we are
pray,
constantly
play.
Inspired
play,
by
play,
your
play,
creativity
play,
and enthusiasm.
Play, 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 play,
Thank
play,
so
play,
much,
play,
play. Thanks for praying, play.
Well, that stuff seems pretty cool for Prey.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I'll go to check that out.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Please welcome
Jens Mattis.
Oh, really?
Gustafsson.
We're already going to...
I said to put it on the bingo, and you said
no? I thought there was no way they could do a Wolfenstein 3 already.
They are
it just came out last year.
Hello, friends.
I still have to play Wolfenstein 2. I haven't gotten around to it yet.
His name is Jerk. That sucks.
Oh, no.
Gustafsson, executive
producer. Yark. His name is Yark.
Oh, okay.
Sup, Jerk.
Oh, no.
Last year, millions of you
call
took
you
to the streets
jerk a lot?
And sparked a revolution in Wolfenstein 2, The New Colossus. As BJ Blazkowicz, you rallied the American resistance.
Make him go to Mars.
Make him go to Mars. BJ goes to Mars.
Those Nazis.
Yeah.
Thank you for embracing our game. We were honored to win Best Action Game at the Game Awards last December.
Oh, yeah. This guy looks like that guy with the glasses
and
if he was nicer.
And we are excited to bring Wolfenstein 2
a little, yeah.
Friendly.
To Switch on June 29th so you can fight the Nazis on,
on
the go.
On
June. Yeah.
And the Wolfenstein Revolution continues with our next project, which leaps ahead in time to tell the tale of BJ's twin daughters.
Oh. I thought it was going to be about his great-great-great-great-grandkid, Math Blaster. Isn't that who it is?
Not Math Blaster.
Pushes the story forward.
That font for Youngblood almost looks like the...
It looks like a...
GoldenEye font?
Yeah, GoldenEye font, yeah. Commander Keen, Commander Keen.
Commander Keen, yeah.
Math Blaster's his great-great-great-grandcousin.
Wolfenstein Youngblood will be a co-op.
Don't you mean Junebug?
Oh, it's co-op, too.
Oh, that guy's really happy.
Once you play solo, you can also join with a friend to save the world together.
Join with a friend.
Hey, look, we got a new co-op game.
Yeah. I was telling you to put it on the bingo that there's going to be a new Wolfenstein. You were like, no.
No way. I thought it was too soon.
Oh, they're hot on the tail of more Wolfenstein.
That really looks like the GoldenEye font for me.
Listen, children. I've been fighting all my life for this world. It never ends. They're gonna send everything they have at you. To survive, you have to embrace the suffering. To stand up and carry it. It's not about the pain you can deal. It's about how much you can take.
It's do or die, sis.
Oh man, they got those fucking suits.
Woo! I'm hyped. That's exciting.
That's cool.
Neat.
Who coughed?
Hi.
Oh.
At Bethesda, that we're proud of our...
mightily yawning. Wow.
Yeah,
wow.
He suddenly appeared on stage using his Ninpo.
We revealed at E3 2012.
He's going to leave stage with just like throwing a smoke bomb and he's gone.
From Doom to Fallout 4 to Skyrim. And we're not
the guy
done.
Back there was yawning so big. I thought
he was gonna
swallow his own head.
It's
so
contagious.
When Prey's Typhon Hunter is released later this summer, you'll be able to experience the competitive mode that Susan and Ricardo were just talking about in virtual reality. And it will also include a single player experience that puts you in the boots of Transstar employees working to solve puzzles aboard the Talos 1 space station.
Yes!
I'm also excited to announce
puzzles, Talos.
VR game.
Talos Principle. It's all mixing up here.
It's called Wolfenstein Cyberpilot, in which you play a hacker who can take over Nazi robots and turn these war machines against their masters.
Woo!
And our ever-ending quest to bring the message of fuck Nazis to every platform possible.
Bless you.
I wonder how... Okay, so if they're announcing multiple Wolfenstein things, they're probably going to be smaller
games. Both the Prey and Wolfenstein VR experiences are playable this week.
I wonder how that previous game is
going to
play
then. So please stop by and give them a try. Now, we are really excited about everything that we've shown here tonight, but I know there are a lot of you who are really here or really wondering about
The F word.
76. And I'm pleased to tell you
it's canceled.
That your wait is finally over. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the recipient of numerous Lifetime Achievement and Hall of Fame awards. He's the game director at a studio that has won a bevy of accolades and awards.
Bevy.
And he's here tonight to tell us what he and his team have been taking so damn long to tell us all about. Will you please welcome my very good friend, Mr. Todd Howard.
It doesn't even feel like Fallout 4 came out that long ago. When did Fallout 4 come out?
I don't know.
20...
I don't know.
15, 2016? It has only been a couple of years. 3 years. It's been 3 years. Thank you, chat.
It came out November 10th, 2015.
Yeah. Not that long. No? There's a teleprompter. Look at that. Mm-hmm. Maybe it was fucking up earlier.
Oh, mm-hmm. It's great to be back at E3. Thank you. Thank you so much. I could not be more excited to be here. I want to thank all our fans who came out tonight.
Something about Todd Howard makes him look like a cult leader.
Watching online, we can't thank you enough.
I'm not really seeing
this is
that.
Actually, no, I don't know what it is. 25th year.
He
no,
does
no offense.
He does look like.
There's a bit of
somebody.
Like a,
he reminds me of somebody, yeah. But I don't remember who.
I have seen a lot of cool things in that time. I gotta say, tonight is definitely
the
definitely
jacket's so
one
shiny.
Of them. I got to go to the very first E3. Right here in Los Angeles. I know. They're so cute when they're little. They're full of energy and life. And then, remember when little E3 ran away from home, went to Atlanta? Yes. A lot of you didn't come. I liked Atlanta.
Oh, he's from that one game.
Or
yeah.
East Coast.
Rage.
And then E3 went through the moody teen years and came back and locked itself in its room. Remember, it was in the convention
Talk about
center.
Fallout. Nobody wants to hear your bad stand-up.
Just in the meeting rooms. They didn't invite anybody. And I can remember literally walking between the halls and seeing nobody. I was like, this is how a zombie movie starts. And now E3 has grown up. It's in its 20s. It's more confident. Can handle its alcohol better, like all of you. Thank you.
I don't know about that last part about handling the alcohol.
So there's a good party after this, so pace yourselves. And I hope you're comfortable, by the way. I'm gonna be here.
What if
for
that
a
one
while.
Guy was still yawning? I barely saw him on camera.
And
again.
E3 has become such an incredible week of entertainment.
Guy back there.
But we
like,
know
moving his
that
head back to forth to be on camera
for one thing.
That guy. Todd Howard. Here for Todd Howard.
Is that what that guy
That's
said?
That guy screamed Todd Howard.
Maybe I should have made a box on the bingo card that just says Todd Howard because you hear his name a lot.
Yeah.
Well, I think we have the best one yet.
The Elder Scrolls speak of the past and the future. Now, Skyrim looks to the future, to its ultimate version.
What is he doing here?
No, TI-86
Alexa,
graphing calculator.
Play Skyrim.
You're level 57 and see a tall snowy mountain.
Climb it.
Now, Skyrim and life become one.
A mud crab scuttles towards
first
me.
Rodar.
I didn't catch that.
First Rodar!
I didn't quite catch that.
First Rodar!
Your shout echoes all the way to Sovngarde.
What happened?
First Rodar. That's the command for knocking things over.
Is there a command for picking shit up?
Haven't reached that level yet.
I'm sworn to carry your burdens.
Okay, some decent jokes.
Okay.
You have 7% health left.
Oh, shit. I drink a health potion.
You are out of health potions.
How many wheels of cheese do I have left?
473.
Okay, I eat all the cheese. I eat all of the cheese.
Hey, hun. Remember what the doctor said about dairy?
Yes, right, yes, of course. You're the greatest.
That doesn't make sense.
I eat all of the cheese.
Introducing Skyrim, very special edition. Also coming soon to Etch-A-Sketch.
Oh my God!
Jesus Christ, they're making the fucking jokes for us.
And your Samsung smart refrigerator.
Oh, that's cool.
They made the jokes for us. They didn't even have to do it.
Oh my God, you made the joke on the thing.
I guess I gotta check it off now.
Yeah.
Where is it?
Had to do it. Okay, really.
Skyrim ported everything. You can check it off. They made the joke.
To talk about the next Fallout.
Fine. Good joke.
Good joke.
Well done.
It was funny.
Fallout 76 is a prequel to all the other games, and it's our biggest one yet. It is 4 times the size of Fallout 4.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Whoa. Those guys in the back are like freaking out. That guy in the white in the front.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my God.
And very different wasteland.
West Virginia.
Oh boy, get ready.
Blue Ridge Mountain.
I should have made a fucking like counter for how many times you hear this song. Just throughout all of E3.
Almost heaven.
I think this is the same trailer, actually.
West Virginia. We already saw this ton.
Hmm. 300 years after our great nation began.
So, are you excited to hear this song again?
Yep. Can't get enough of it.
Sprawling underground shelter may have been engineered.
Everyone
by
sing along. I'm sure you know all the words by now.
So that if the bombs do come, our way of life will endure.
Almost heaven. West Virginia. Sing along, everybody. Blue Ridge Mountain. Shenandoah River.
I wouldn't care. Would you count this as old-timey music?
Older than the trees.
I don't think it's old.
I don't think it's old enough. This is like a 70s song or something? 60s?
I don't know, actually. But when I say old-timey, I'm thinking like, you know.
Ink spots.
Yeah, ink spots. Shit that was used in the several decades ago.
John Denver's songs was probably the 60s.
Yeah, I don't count 60s as old-timey.
71.
Yeah.
This ain't old.
I don't think so.
And the fallout has settled.
It's dad age.
Not just walls, not just buildings, but
that's
hearts,
that Pazuzu ass thing up there, man.
And ultimately, America itself. In Vault 76, our future begins.
Yes!
Vault 76, one of the very first vaults to open, was built to celebrate America's tercentenary, which is an awesome word, by the way. Like, that's your word of the night, tercentenary. You are one of the very special few selected to be an occupant
so much.
And spend 25 years underground.
He's got a lot of room to move around,
yeah.
So might as well utilize it.
Day. The day the vault opens.
Bye.
Good morning, Vault 76. This is the Overseer. I hope you all enjoyed the party last night.
It's weird to see a vault with color.
I know, right?
And overslept, but it's time to get up and get out there. We've been locked away long enough. Today is Reclamation Day.
Oh,
Finally! I feared you'd never wake up. Don't you remember? Time to leave the vault! Most mm-hmm. of the others have already gone.
I like the Mr. Handies. Hmm? I like the Mr. Handies.
Yeah, they have a cute voice.
You come from every walk of life, every race, color, and creed. But you all share one very important trait. You are this country's best and brightest. But more importantly, you'll always be my family.
Goodbye! Aloha! Ciao!
Mega ultra widescreen.
We always start with the world, and this time it features all new rendering, lighting, and landscape technology.
It does look nicer.
It allows us to have 16 times the detail.
Well, the people look normal, is the question.
Systems across the map. Now, most people don't know West Virginia that well. It is an incredible array of natural wonders, towns,
and government
secrets.
Is that fucking song going to play like whenever you pull up the map or something? Like in Far Cry 5?
The overseer sends
just imagine
you on
every
will take
time.
You through
it's gonna be in my head for years now.
Regions, each with their own style, risks, and rewards. There's plenty of cool new Fallout creatures, and we even use the folklore of West Virginia
Mothman. Mothman.
Oh, look at him.
Mothman. Gollum.
I think that guy's from The Witcher 3, actually.
Mothman!
Oh! Yeah.
Motherfucking Mothman!
We have always wanted to tell that story of what it will be like for you and the other characters who were first to leave the vaults. But there is one big difference with this game.
There's Mothman in
it. That each of those characters is a real person.
Yeah, the rumors about the multiplayer stuff is real. Oh, look, it's fucking
Battle Royale mode.
That guy was wearing that Goku shirt.
Is entirely fucking online.
Did you say it's entirely online?
Entirely.
Okay. I know, there's a lot. You have like 1,000 questions right now. So I'm going
to
go through them in
order.
To be
entirely online, or...?
Now, I'll hit a couple of the big ones. First, of course, you can play this solo.
Okay.
All right? You'll be who you want, exploring a huge world, doing quests, experiencing a story, and leveling up. We love those things about our games, too. It would not have it any other way. But also, like many of you, we have always wanted to see what our style of game could be with multiplayer. So many of us talk about experiences in our games, but we've never experienced them together. So about 4 years ago, we hit upon an idea that is perfect for Fallout. Open world, survival, every person.
Making the cameraman earn their paycheck here.
Real. And it was an idea that we just couldn't shake. We knew we had to do it and do it in a really big way. Now, I know you may have played survival modes in like some of our previous games or some other online games, and we, you know, people wonder, is this hardcore survival? I like to think of it maybe it's more softcore survival. Maybe that should be a new ESRB descriptor. Death never means the loss of progression or the loss of your character. Your character isn't tied to one server. As a matter of fact, you'll never even see a server when you play. You'll be in a world with dozens, not hundreds and not thousands, of other players. It's the apocalypse. It's not an amusement park, okay?
and you'll be able to join your friends whenever you want, and all of your progression goes with you.
Cool. Nice. Good idea. Yeah. All right.
When we think about games, we think about worlds and the choices that you can make, the stories that you create and tell yourself. By creating a wide open world with very few rules, we have a game more than any game that we've ever done where the choices are yours, where you'll decide what happens. You'll decide the heroes and you'll decide the villains. Look, this is a whole new world for all of us here. And fortunately, our friends at Vault-Tec have made a series of informational videos for when all of us emerge together.
Yeah! I love these!
Cute. It's really cute.
Cute presentation.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
As you venture out into this new American frontier, some of your fellow survivors may not be neighborly.
Oh God, you gotta pack it.
Chin up there, sport. Not all Vault 76 dwellers will be so hostile. Find them and brave the new world together. Whether you choose to explore the wasteland alone or with friends, your days will be filled with fun activities. Run like a rabbit, fly like a bee. No matter what you do, you'll never
What the fuck?
God, that thing is terrifying. Aww.
Wow, big fucking sloth.
Slothman. Wow.
If it's basically just like a normal Fallout game, but you can choose to do co-op or attack other people.
That's nice.
You can play this game solo in quests. But the easiest way to survive in the wasteland is to team up and build together. And in this one, you can build wherever you want. And you can also then move that to wherever
base building stuff.
I love these jam handy
nuclear war,
things.
Man's towering industrial marvels may no longer stretch to the heavens. What separates man from beast? It is his desire to build. Get started with camps. The construction and assembly mobile platform. Construct your home of the future. With your home secure, you can now craft and make weapons at your leisure to give your altercations that personal touch. It falls on you and the ingenuity of your fellows to rebuild the America we hold dear.
Going to the can.
But don't become too attached too quickly. Monitor your environment for anything out of the ordinary. The home of tomorrow.
Oh my God, it's that bat thing.
Yeah.
The Scorch Beast. Oh Lord.
After a crisis, work with your neighbors to ensure success. There's no I in nuclear wasteland. Document your adventures. Your memories will shape the new
Every
American
game
dream.
Should have a photo mode.
Yeah,
I agree with this.
I agree.
Nice poses. That one of the right almost a JoJo pose.
There goes the neighborhood.
the mods still work when it's like online? Can I mod JoJo poses in the photo mode? That would be rad.
Yeah, we love dynamic game systems. So we thought, why don't we put multiple nuclear missile sites on the map? And then let all of you do whatever you want with them.
Today's episode, Atomics for Peace. When you emerge from the comfort and safety of your vault, the world you know will have changed. Take your friendly old neighbor, Johnny. Rather than coming over to borrow a cup of sugar, he may now be coming over for murder. The time has come to seek out greater means of protection. Nuclear armaments. That's right. Courtesy of your Uncle Sam, these wonders of the atomic age can be found right in your own backyard. But how does a fella like you acquire nuclear weapons, you may ask? Begin by inquiring with the locals. Gently coax them into cooperation. Use a little elbow grease if you have to. In the likely event you don't acquire a full code on your own, do not give up. Search for others who might be harboring a grudge. You'll have that nuclear launch code in no time. With the power of the atom at your fingertips, be responsible and consider your target carefully.
Attention. Launch sequence activated.
Will your bomb land on a rival camp of degenerates? A random stranger? The local wildlife? Whatever your target may be, take advantage of the resulting fallout to gather rare and valuable resources.
Yeah, so they have alternate versions of every chunk of the map?
Yet these rewards don't come without risk. The fate of this new world is yours to command with the power of the atom.
We know you've played a lot of our games and a lot of online games, but this one really is unique. We have built a platform, 100% dedicated servers that will support this game now and for years to come. And look, we know this is new for all of you. It's new for us. It's a little bit scary. And to that end, we're gonna need your help. Because yes, we are going to have a beta.
I was gonna make a joke to say, we have a Kickstarter to fund this.
Tech as well. The Break It Early test application. Because evidently, these online games are hard. They can have some nasty issues. I read on the internet that our games have had a few bugs. I did. I read it on the internet, so it's true. And that sometimes it doesn't just work. Anyway, we know together that we are going to build something really special. And we also know that all of you love our special editions. And we have an awesome collector's edition for you. It starts with a map of the world that glows
love me some
in
maps.
The fucking dark.
Oh! Everyone loves that shit. Right.
So cool. It comes with figures you can put on the map, and it also comes with a Fallout collectible that really I've always wanted, so we made them for everybody to buy, and here it is.
Is it a game that goes with it?
Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool
down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ooh. Ain't no use in diving. What's the use of diving? Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top.
Yes, all of this, the Fallout 76. Cool.
Thundering outside, but it's just the dude's base edition. Upstairs.
So you're probably wondering, when is this game coming out? We're excited to say
tomorrow
that it's coming out this year, November 14th.
Wow. Nice.
Thanks again for all your support of Fallout. It's been 10 years since Fallout 3, our very first one. And it's been an incredible journey with all of you.
It's funny that Fallout 3 was the first one.
Another Fallout anniversary that we are celebrating here at E3. It is the 3-year anniversary of Fallout Shelter, which we announced and released right here at E3.
Release the sequel so I can check a thing off my bingo card.
Some cool surprises for you. Fallout Shelter is coming to the PlayStation 4. And because that guy said it, it's also coming to the Nintendo Switch.
Hey. That makes sense.
You can play it with the Joy-Cons or touch controls. And yes, it's still free.
Cool.
And excited to say these versions are coming out tonight.
People asking why, what's the point? Because they want their game on more platforms.
Again,
so people spend
so
money on it. There's still in-app purchases.
There's still in-app purchases.
What, like,
what's the question
tonight?
Here? They want to make more money.
Our game.
The reason companies do anything.
Everybody would want to port everything to everything unless they have some agreement that lets them get more money for not porting it to that thing.
And some people have shitty phones that can't, like, that don't have space for the
shit.
Yeah,
you had to play on my tablet because your iPhone would crash.
My phone would crash.
More people than every game.
Some people have a Switch and don't have a nice phone.
Combined. Incredible. It
Woo,
does kind of make
if I
you
do
stop
say so myself.
And realize that our games can have new lives on any type of device or system. And you know, when we looked at the iPhone 11 years ago, we had a few ideas for mobile games. Fallout Shelter was one of them.
Oh.
And we did have another one that was far, far more ambitious.
Oh.
And we've been building it.
What's and going it's on
I did say Elder Scrolls mobile game.
That you love from us.
This is Elder Scrolls mobile game.
It is called The Elder Scrolls Blades.
Yeah, I get to check this off now.
So many almost bingos happening.
Like Fallout Shelter, we wanted an experience that we were not finding anywhere else. Here it is.
Some people might
Blades
have a bingo, but
its heart
I don't yet.
Is a pure Elder Scrolls
cards
game.
Randomly place the squares,
massive
so I'll look at
first
that.
First-person RPG with console quality graphics, but with a uniquely mobile experience. Believe me when I say you have to see this running on an iPhone 10. This gigantic screen does not do it justice. You can
even see it on a tiny screen.
Or use dual sticks. Combat is all new, and it follows your specific movements and timings. Harkening back to the first Elder Scrolls Arena,
well, we're harkening.
This game features both handcrafted and procedurally generated dungeons.
The next Devolvers is at 10,
you have a range
which is 15
of
minutes from now.
Yeah, they're probably butting right up against each other.
Wrap it up, Todd! I'm hungry, I want to make a sandwich.
You're not going to have
course,
time.
I know,
because I'm
eating during the stream. People going to hate
you
me.
Want to be. Improving
eat
them,
away from the microphone, please.
Leveling up, new abilities.
So people really do not like
they
chewing noises.
They hate it.
They hate it.
And And the entire game can be played in portrait mode.
Somebody said thank
that one
you.
Was incredibly thank important you. To us that you could play it however you wanted.
Use the bathroom, make a sandwich.
You never know when you'll need a free hand. To hold your coffee, what do you... Degenerates. And it's not just dungeons. It's incredible outdoor areas. Yes, running on a phone. It really looks and plays incredible.
I'm just happy I can cross off my bingo card. Still don't have a bingo though. Come on. Am I even close to one? I would need new IP and Rogue Warriors sequel to get a bingo one way.
Blaze has several modes of play. First, the
Yeah, that's the closest I'm getting to a bingo. Rogue Warriors sequel, new IP.
See how far you can go in an endless dungeon. And the arena, where you will do battle one-on-one against other players. And the main mode, the town. This is the hub for your story and quests.
Oh wait, I forgot to check off Doom 2.
Of the Blades.
Oh. Boop. Still not anywhere close to a bingo though.
Forced in exile.
If things were just a little down and to the right. Yeah.
Everything releasing soon, I think we can check off. Because pretty much everything's coming out this year that they've announced.
A town building mode. You'll decide what your town looks like and be able to upgrade and decorate all of
okay, no, you what? I can also check off. Well,
as your town levels up,
maybe they'll announce something else after this. But I was about to check off nothing is Battle Royale. I know people are going to say, but Fallout 76 is Battle Royale,
no,
but it's not.
That's not the definition.
It's like a dozen players max or something like that, not 100 people. And the goal of the game isn't to be the last person alive, it's just multiplayer.
This is an Elder Scrolls game that you can play however and wherever you want. And we are going to bring Blades to every device and system we can. Phones, PCs, consoles, also virtual reality.
On mobile, there's VR stuff too, so yeah, I can cross off VR games.
VR on PCs. And what's really cool is all of those connect to each other.
No bingo.
No.
So one of my dreams, so we'll go back to that portrait mode, which I like to call meeting mode. Because if you're in a meeting on your playing a game, in portrait mode, no one knows you're playing a game. And so with Blades, you could be in a meeting playing Blades against someone at home in VR. Blades is coming this fall for free. And you can pre-order it tonight on both the Apple App Store and the Google Play Store. Also, this week, go to playblades.com and register for early access. If you're here at E3, Blades is going to be playable in our booth. So please, come by and check it out. You really need to see it running on the phone. We'd love to see you. Please come by. I just want to thank you all again, all of our fans here, everybody watching online, for all of your support over the years. It is so exciting to show you all that we have coming out this year, and it is an honor and a blessing.
Okay, it's 9:50, they're wrapping up, but are they going to show Starfield?
We have 3 offices now in Maryland, Montreal, and Austin. There's a lot of them here tonight. I want them to hear your appreciation for their work.
Damn, that guy ain't even clapping.
He's done.
Just the best team and group of people I could ever hope for. Amazing. We also thought, since we're all here together tonight and it's so special, maybe we'd do something a little different too. and tell you what we have coming beyond this year in the future.
Yeah, they're going to show something else. It's probably Starfield.
We have also been working on a brand new next generation single player game.
I guess I can also cross off focus still on single player games for the
but
most
this
part.
One is in an all new epic franchise.
Also, it's a new IP, so I can
Our
cross that off.
First wholly original franchise in 25 years. We're excited to announce our next adventure.
All right, here's the thing.
All right.
Very, yeah, chat, we did get, and it's out today on the card. Yeah. Yep, Starfield is real.
That's vague.
Huh?
That was vague.
Yeah, too bad I didn't have that in this card. Vague CD trailer.
That was very vague.
Starfield is real.
Starfield is a game that we have spent years thinking about and working on. Something we feel uniquely positioned to pull off and that we're incredibly excited about. But we're also building toward the game after that.
Oh, they talk another game?
And it's the one you keep asking about.
Okay, they're making a new Elder Scrolls too, I think. Yeah, it's gonna be Elder Scrolls, isn't it? Okay, yep. Elder Scrolls announced. No footage. Check that off.
Okay, actually, now I'm really done. I just want to thank
okay,
you
he's
all
actually
for your
done
time
now.
Tonight. The time you've spent in our worlds. We'll see you out there.
Okay, nothing was Battle Royale. Also, I'm going to say, normal conference, no complaints. I finally got a bingo.
Bingo!
Almost everything is checked off.
There's only five new squares.
Six.
Another round of applause, please, for Todd Howard.
Finally got a bingo. Damn.
We only get him up here like once every
three.
Boy, when he shows
card.
Up, he brings the goods. Thanks also to all of our studios and teams around the world who are so dedicated to giving our fans the very best games. If you're a gamer on any platform of any kind, we think we've got something for you. And I hope you're as excited about what you've seen tonight as we are, whether it's a new Fallout game, a new Elder Scrolls game from Bethesda Game Studios that you can play on your phone for free.
I have a sandwich, but it's on a different surface. I'm going to be eating it at a diagonal away from the microphone. Wish me luck, everybody.
Okay, it's still probably going to get picked up a bit.
Well, I still need to watch the damn fucking thing.
It's easy and it's free. For all of you here with us tonight, thank you so much for joining. The party is going to continue afterwards. For everyone else around the world, thank you so much for joining us. Everyone have a good night and a great E3.
Okay, chat. Devolver Digital is starting extremely soon.
So soon. So now.
So here in the chat is the bingo card for Devolver Digital. If you also refresh the page, because I don't know if it updates on its own, the link for that is also below the stream on Twitch. Okay. Well, that shift's happening. We are gonna go back to the waiting screen, and I'm gonna find where Devolver Digital stream is at.
Mm.